You may think we're in Russia because of the church behind me, but we're actually in Germany, in Darmstadt. We're here to meet the professor, Marc Hassenzahl, who is a professor in user experience and experience design. And this is what he's going to tell us more about in his home here in Darmstadt. So Marc, what is user experience, experience design, as well as experience? It's all related so close, but can you tell us what you think it is?
Yeah, I think it's really difficult to take all these different things apart. But let me start with the term user experience, a term I kind of dislike a bit, mm-hmm. because of that focus on usage only and the user, and it, you know, it's like as if it would be so closely rooted only in action. But experience is a much broader field, I would say. So I would like rather like to talk about experiences or experiencing later on, and experience design as the way to create that experiences. Mm-hmm. For me, user experience is just a field of study. So there happen to be some people in the context of interactive products coming out of the usability community that thought maybe we should change our models a bit, and they came up with this word. And I think it's called user because usability was always very deeply rooted in usage. And when people invented that term, you know, it hadn't been the consumer, but naturally the user. Mm-hmm. And experience is just, shall I say, it's just a more focus on the user, on it, his or her psychology, on emotions and stuff like that. So just stressing that we should even more focus on the user. Mm-hmm. But over the time, somehow people started to take that experience term literally and try to explore, you know, what would it mean, mm-hmm. if we really would design for experiences, not just take that as a term for denoting more more closeness to people. And I think that started like 6 or 7 years ago. People started to think about what it actually is, and publications popped up. Mm-hmm. And
so,
now, yeah.
So designing with this in mind, what could you give examples of any products?
Basically, I think there are not that much products out there at the moment. I would like to distinguish two different kinds of ways of looking at the experience. Mm-hmm. One is, you have something like a moment by moment experience. So in that moment, you feel somehow, you do something, you think, mm-hmm. you, and that all that together is like this experience you have in the moment. And this focus very much on, you know, what we do and what we think in a particular moment. Mm-hmm. And focuses also very much on the how. So if you use a product, on how does it feel? You know, how to touch, does it look like, how is it in your hands, how does it fit and stuff like that. This is one way of looking at experience. And I think a product like the iPhone or the iPod touch with this new way of interacting with a multi-touch and physics model beneath, that's more catering to this kind of experience. Mm-hmm. I would prefer calling it the aesthetics of interaction. So for me, it's not really the thing I'm after.
Mm-hmm. What are you after?
Yeah, I'm more after like, I think, you know, this window of consciousness, the moment by moment experience you have is just 3 seconds or whatever. Mm-hmm. It's very, very small. And the most of our times we're working on memories of experiences we have, and they are quite different, because the moment you experience something, you have it in you encode it somehow in your memory, and you're trying to make sense of it, mm-hmm. to create meaning. You forget things. What you do is you construct a story of usage, and it has a beginning and end, it has a structure, and this is what you actually remember, this is what you will communicate to other people, this is the reality, mm-hmm. you had with the product. And this is nothing new. I mean, that's actually how we as humans,
yeah.
Define ourselves. We even have our own memory system for that, episodic memory that stores these stories of our lives. And as long as we interact with certain kind of technology, we create that stories as well. Mm-hmm. This is my idea of experience. So if you put it more academically, then it's the difference between experiencing, I would say, and an experience mm-hmm. as a story, as a narrative. And I would like to design for those, for these stories. Mm-hmm. So that would either, on one hand, that would mean that we have to understand what these stories contain, what is in it, what is important in that stories. Are they all very personal? So will we ever have the same story, or can we talk about it? Will you understand my stories and vice versa? And how can we use that stories to put them into products? Mm-hmm. And the design part would then be retelling a story or telling a story through a product.
Can you give an example? Because it's kind of an intangible.
Yeah, way. I understand. For me, I mean, there are not that many products around, but the Wake Up Light by Philips mm-hmm. is for me a very good example. For those who don't know it, I have one here. So it looks like this. And what it does is you set a certain wake up time mm-hmm. and half an hour before that, it starts lighting up and it gets brighter and brighter. And the moment you want it to get up, it plays back the sound of birds mm-hmm. and or some bells or so, whatever you like. And you can see the story through that object. You can see how they went to people, mm-hmm. asked them, you know, what is your favorite way of waking up? Mm. And they said, oh, I hate my alarm clock, but sometimes, you know, if I don't have to get up, and the sun rises and I'm just woken by the light and I hear the birds, and that's a very nice situation.
Yeah.
So now the problem is that life doesn't work like that. Mm-hmm. So we can't have that experience all the time. But the product tries to give it mm-hmm. to
Anyways.
Us, even in situations, even like a surrogate mm-hmm. experience, even yeah. in situations where we can't have it. And now you can say, that's questionable mm-hmm. because it's just fake. But that's not, I don't believe in that. I think it can work like, you know, love novels work. Mm-hmm. They're surrogate experiences. It's not the real thing, but it's still more meaningful to us than a ringing alarm clock. Mm-hmm. You know, and this is a very technical solution. This would be a more
in between
experiential solution,
yeah.
I would say. And then the interesting thing is, you know, if you look at that design-wise, you know, I'm an industrial designer. I think it's nothing very special. It's not even very beautiful, I would say. And the interaction is a bit awkward mm-hmm. and so on. And this matters, definitely matters. And it should be better. Mm-hmm. But the basic thing about it is this experience it creates.
Yeah.
And in that sense, it doesn't matter much to the user whether this is, you know, is ugly or not. Mm-hmm. It's more like a stand-in or a placeholder for a certain experience you can have.
Mm-hmm.
And this is, I think, quite different from, for example, something like the iPhone.
Yeah.
Because
Could you describe the difference briefly?
The iPhone is, for me, it's just an infrastructure. It's a nice mobile phone. The interesting part, the experiential part, is what the applications people load on it, because that will create new opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
But what they actually did is they took that gadget and they designed a very nice aesthetics of interaction. And it feels good. But it's an experience created by the product, mm-hmm. you know? Only valid for the product, so in that sense.
Yeah.
And I think it's quite a difference, because it puts the product in the fore.
Mm.
It makes it something. It's only, you know, it's novel and special, and I can show it around, a very materialistic
mm-hmm.
thing mm-hmm. in that sense. It also feels better maybe than some buttons or something, but it's all, you know, it's the iPhone says, you know, I'm so cool, I'm so different, you can have, you know, it just feels better working with me. And I would be more in products where you just, you know, forget the whole product
mm-hmm.
and then care about the experience.
So this is more post-materialistic.
Exactly.
You still have a product, but the product is not in the focus.
It's like, I like that expression. It transcends its encasing.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't think that the iPhone does it with the application stores, for mm-hmm. example, because it gives people, it opens up possibilities.
Mm-hmm.
You can write your own application, put it there. You can have everything on that infrastructure, but the experience is in the application,
mm-hmm.
not in the interaction with the device. I think we can still have technological progress in consumer electronics, but at a certain point it becomes just silly. You know, you can't. What else can you put into a mobile phone?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can't imagine much more. So first we had the functions, then we had the aesthetics of interaction. Now everybody has a touchscreen. So what are the next steps?
Mm-hmm.
And I think then at a certain point we will switch from a more technology-driven innovation to again socially driven or human driven innovations, where we just use the same technologies all the time as infrastructure, but come up with new experiences.
Mm-hmm. So this way of designing with the experience in mind, is it something new or has it always been like this?
For me, I think it's something new, and the difference is that although we also in the usability community, everybody always said that they have the user in mind.
Mm-hmm.
They still very much focused on the product and on the technology used. And I think it's quite natural because that's where the skills are.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when if you're a manufacturer of telephones, mobile phones, you know the technology of mobile phones. So naturally you tend to argue, hey, I'm manufacturing those and I'm selling those, so I want to make them good, but you know, it's still the technology I'm designing. And usability is exactly doing that, making it easier, but never questioning the model behind that. Never questioning, is a mobile phone the right way, right device or so. You know, we are on that shift from a more materialistic to a more post-materialistic society, which means the post-materialistic means that I'm much more care about positive experiences I had in my life. I'm not caring about possessions so much and about having things. Sometimes we want to have, we still want it, but I think it's just different shades of materialism. I have a lot of friends, I'm 40 years old, I have a lot of friends that are in music, and there are plenty of them, they want to have the record. So, but I have also younger friends, they don't care that much, they care about the music.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's like the different shades of materialism. So this if you have that urge to own something, that is more materialistic, and if you have this urge of, you know, just going through something and also owning that, but owning the experience, memories of that, and I think that's why digital cameras are so popular, because people are much more in experiences and they need ways to document it, and because they won't have these material signifiers of their experience. So I think with this change it becomes it is something new, and you can also see that the industry is not so much adapted to it. So
mm-hmm.
if you look at technology manufacturers, they do certain types of technologies.
Yeah.
They're good at. And yeah, I mean they put it in nice casing, they make nice little
mm-hmm.
designs and good interfaces and so on and so on. But still, you know, a phone is a phone is a phone.
Mm-hmm.
They never rethink the whole thing.
Thank you so much, Marc, for sharing some of your knowledge about user experience and experience design. And if you want to know more about it and how to put these insights into use when designing products, you should have a look at our second interview with Marc. And you could also read the chapter he's written at interactiondesign.org. And here you can also find more chapters like his, and you can find more videos like this one as well. Thank you so much for your time and interest.